In the last class we had derived expressions for ISP and non-dimensional thrust for a case with the afterburner switched on, and for the flow through the nozzle we had assumed that the flow is optimally expanded through the nozzle. Now let us take the other case wherein the flow through the nozzle is a choke flow. Okay. And efficiencies are all 1, and we will see how this case looks like. So we had done a very similar analysis without the afterburner being switched on, and we had got this expression for non-dimensional thrust as F by m dot a naught. This was the expression that we had for the non-dimensional thrust for a choke flow through the nozzle with all efficiencies being 1, and this is the same expression that we will have with the afterburner switched on also, only these quantities change. Okay. So for afterburner switched on, we need T7 by T naught, and in the previous class we had seen that this is nothing but theta AB by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M7 squared, right. We know that for a choke flow through the nozzle, what is it that we know? M7 must be equal to 1. So substituting it here, we will get that it this is the expression for T7 by T naught, and similarly we need expression for P7 by P naught. When we cascade, we will get this 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M7 square, right, into pi t pi c okay. This is the expression that we get. Now I also know that I can write pi t as tau t to the power of gamma by, right, and I will substitute these because all of them will then be raised to the same power, so it will be easier for me to handle it. I will get, and I also know that M7 is equal to 1. So substituting this, I will get Okay. So we have got pressure ratios also. Then for getting, we have got this ratio, we need to get this quantity. Okay, just like in the previous case, we will get this by looking at mass flow rate through the nozzle. Considering mass flow rate through the nozzle, we get that m dot a into 1 plus f plus fab in this case must be equal to rho 7 v 7 a 7. Now again we can use what we had done earlier, that f plus fab is very much less than 1, then I will get m dot a is equal to rho 7, I can write it as p 7 by r t 7 into V 7 is A 7 into M 7 okay. This I know is 1 okay for the choke nozzle. So I get A 7 if I write it as gamma r t 7, I will get p 7 into under root gamma a 7 divided by okay. Now again we multiply both sides by a naught. So I get what I was looking for, m dot a naught is equal to p 7 under root gamma, a naught is again gamma r t naught, so I will use that. So I can cancel out r and r here and I will be left with gamma p 7 a 7 t 7. Now if I divide both sides by p naught by P naught A 7, you get the expression that we wanted, m dot a a naught divided by p naught a 7 is equal to gamma into p 7 by p naught okay, and we know the values of both of them, p 7 by p naught and t naught by t 7. So if we substitute it, we will get this is the expression that we get. Now we know all the three quantities that we were looking for, so I can write f by m dot a a naught as equal to under root t 7 by t naught, which is nothing but 2 theta a b by minus m naught plus p naught a 7 by m dot a a naught, that is 1 by gamma into p 7 by p naught minus 1, that is the same quantity. Okay, this is the expression that we get for f by m dot a a naught for an choke flow condition, okay, with the afterburner switched on. You can also similarly get an expression for ISP. Only thing that needs to be changed is that f by m dot a a naught is this expression, right. All the other things in the ISP by a naught expression that we derived earlier holds good. So you just need to change the f by m dot a naught expression. So we have now got both things, that is for an optimally expanded flow and for a choke nozzle. Choke nozzle is the more general case, and optimally expanded flow, as I said, is a very special case of choke nozzle wherein the exit pressure is equal to the ambient pressure, okay. Now just like what we had done earlier, that is look at typical calculations and see what happens with the afterburner turned on, okay. I will use the same set of numbers that I had used for a choked flow in the nozzle. So we will keep the flow in the nozzle as choked and use the same set of parameters and find out what happens with f by m dot a a naught and ISP with the afterburner turned on. So first is takeoff, that is m naught is equal to 0 and at (11 km) altitude, m naught being equal to 0.8. So we look at firstly f by m dot a naught, and then we look at ISP, and SFC is in kg per kgr, and we look at two ratios, that is and and we look at two conditions here, one no AB, that is no afterburner, and then the other one with afterburner. Again here same thing, now we are using all these parameters the same, so I will get f by m dot a naught as 2.27 and 2.15, similar to the last case that we had looked at. Now let's look. Yes, both cases being for the choke nozzle. So let us look at what happens now with the afterburner being switched on. All this is for a choke nozzle. Now let us look at what happens to these values when we switch on the afterburner. With afterburner, this goes to a fairly large value of 3.67, and ISP reduces to 29.5, and this increases to 1.2, and similarly this goes to 3.85 1.37, and this ratio of f by m dot a naught, that is the non-dimensional thrust, how much do we get an increase from with the afterburner being switched on to without it, this ratio would be 1.62 for this case and 1.79 or 1.8 for the second case, okay. And SFC ratio is what we need to pay to get this kind of ratio, if you look at this, okay, what we see is that we need to really shell out a lot more fuel if we have to get a thrust increment by this much. If we have to get in this case 60 to 80% thrust increase, we have to spend something like 50 to 80% on the SFC, right. So it is a very large SFC increase compared to what you get for the thrust. You can also put it the other way, that if the same thing was done, let us say if we had if you remember our discussions wherein we talked about the limitation on turbine inlet temperatures, we said turbine inlet temperatures cannot be raised because of material considerations, and therefore we limit it by using excess air. Now suppose we were free to increase this to a larger value, then the same kind of thrust increase, remember turbine inlet temperature is in the hands, you can give the more fuel to the main burner or less fuel, but there is an overall limit, right, that can be changed within certain limits. If we were allowed to increase the turbine inlet temperature, the same kind of what you see as F by M dot A ratio could have been obtained with same can be obtained with same ratio can be obtained with turbine inlet temperatures could have been increased. Okay. So what we are saying is you are spending 80% increase in SFC, while the same thrust increment could have been got if you were allowed to increase the turbine inlet temperature. This shows the need for, you know, better materials wherein we can go for a larger turbine inlet temperature and wherein you can save on fuel. If you want excess thrust, you can increase the turbine inlet temperature and get the same excess thrust at a much lower cost. Why does this happen? Why do we say that if we increase the turbine inlet temperature, if we are allowed to increase the turbine inlet temperature, the SFC would reduce, whereas if you switch on the afterburner, you see that SFC increase for the same thrust increment is more. Why does this happen?
Exhaust velocities become higher.
That is the one that gives the higher thrust. No, that is not the reason. What I am asking you is, if you look at the two cases, SFC increase with the afterburner switched on is much more for the same thrust increment than the case if we take wherein we are allowed to increase the turbine inlet temperature. Turbine inlet temperature you could have got the same with a 35% increase, whereas you are spending around 80% increase in SFC, to account for the same thrust increment. Why should this happen is my question. Why should burning fuel in the afterburner be more expensive? Now, if you go back to our discussions wherein we talked about the need for the afterburner, I talked about something known as availability, right. If you add heat at a very high pressure, then you have a opportunity to expand for more than if you add heat at a lower, much lower pressure. What we are doing in the afterburner is we are past the turbine where the flow has expanded already and the pressures are very low, and there we are trying to add heat, which means that the opportunity to expand is smaller, and therefore we find that the SFC will increase because you are now expanding from a lower pressure to an even lower pressure, and but you are spending more fuel to increase that temperature. Okay. Okay. Now let's look at the next method of getting thrust augmentation that we discussed earlier. That is water methanol injection. Okay. Now, if you remember our earlier discussions, I had said that you can add water in the main combustor, and that will, because the flow at the exit of the combustor is choked, it will act as though it is increasing the pressure inside the combustor. Okay, and we use water for that. Now, water at very low temperatures that are encountered at higher altitudes would tend to freeze. So, therefore, we need to add some additives to make sure that it doesn't freeze. Now, that's why methanol is added, and also methanol provides the additional heat that is required to increase the temperature of water from ambient to the turbine inlet temperatures. Okay, so let's look at how this system works. So we are going to consider the case where water and methanol are injected in the main combustor. Okay. Now, what is our non-dimensional thrust equation? That is for optimally expanded flow and eta being 1. Okay. So, this is the expression that we had for non-dimensional thrust for these conditions, right. Now, if we are injecting water and methanol in the main combustor, I need to add a term here. Okay, it is not just 1 plus F, it should be F plus, I will call this FW, whereas where FW is nothing but m dot mass flow rate of water plus methanol divided by mass flow rate of air. Okay, so this is the expression that we have. Now here in this case I cannot say that combining these two it is much less than 1, because we will see that you can increase this to something like 30% of the overall flow. So I cannot neglect this part compared to 1, so I will have to retain it and do all the rest of the algebra. Again we need expressions for T7 by T0 and M7 by M0. Okay. Now in this case if you look at the expressions that we have derived for M7 by M0, okay, we had got earlier M7 by M0 as equal to theta naught minus 1 and T7 by T0 as equal to theta b by tau c theta naught, right. Both these expressions do not change. The only change in this case comes about when we are looking at the compressor turbine power balance. If you are adding water methanol in the combustor, all the other expressions, these expressions remain the same. The only change will come in the compressor turbine power balance. We will look at how that happens. So I will say no changes here to the case without water methanol injection. Okay, so let's look at the compressor turbine power balance. Okay. Now, as I had said, if you have if you add water in the combustor, there are two things that happens. One is the flow is choked at the exit of the combustor. If the flow is choked, then we know that it is only a function of upstream conditions. Upstream you are increasing the mass flow rate, right. You are adding water and methanol, you are increasing the mass flow rate, which means that the pressure upstream will also have to increase. So what it essentially does is increases the pressure ratio across the turbine. Okay. It acts as though the compressor pressure ratio is higher. Fine. So this combustion chamber pressure increases, and therefore we find that it acts as though the compressor pressure ratio is increased. Now earlier we had a compressor pressure ratio of pi c, okay, now which was nothing but PT3 by PT2. Now because of the addition of water and methanol in the main combustor, this will get changed to, this will become pi c naught into 1 plus f plus f w divided by 1 plus f. That is, this is the new compressor pressure ratio. It is the earlier compressor pressure ratio, excuse me, it is the earlier compressor pressure ratio that you have multiplied by the increased mass flow rate divided by the earlier mass flow rate. So this is the new compressor pressure ratio that you will get. So if you look at the equation for the turbine compressor power balance, what you will get is m dot a Cp because this pressure ratio across the compressor has changed, it acts as though the pressure ratio, you will find that you can also express this as in terms of tau c naught, right, and if we do the analysis, if we do this analysis, what we will get is the expression for tau t as equal to, earlier it was 1 minus theta naught by theta b into tau c minus 1, this was the earlier expression. Now there is an additional mass flow rate that is going through, you if you remember we had neglected 1 plus f which would be in the denominator. Now there is an additional mass flow rate that is going through and that cannot be neglected, so you will have 1 plus f plus f w here, okay, and the tau c part, pi c was earlier different, now the new tau c would be new tau c would be equal to tau c naught into 1 plus f w divided by 1 plus f So this is the expression that you will have for tau c, and if you plug it back in you will get the new expression for tau t. So you will get finally tau t is equal to 1 minus theta naught by theta b into tau c naught 1 plus f plus fw divided by 1 plus f So what really happens is the actual value of tau t, because you have increased the mass flow rate and because you have increased the pressure upstream of the turbine, both the pressure and the temperature at the end of the turbine would be higher than compared to without water methanol injection, which means that if you expand this flow through the nozzle, you have more scope for expansion, as well as the temperature at the end of expansion would be much higher, therefore you get a larger thrust. Now obviously you have to pay for it, so ISP has got to be higher in this case. Why should ISP be higher?
Water has to be evaporated.
Yes, water we are injecting as a spray. This needs to be water, which is at T naught, needs to be increased to the turbine inlet temperature. So you need to obviously burn fuel to do this.
So we are adding methanol also.
Yes, but still the latent heat you have to provide for, no? At least to bring it up to TT3, you need to provide for it. So this will mean that there is an increase in ISP. So if you take a look at ISP by A naught expression, it will change to Q by Cp T naught into, earlier we were neglecting this part, 1 plus f plus fw we have to have. Earlier we did not have this fw and we said f is very much smaller, so we neglected it. Now you have that part into theta b minus tau c theta naught plus L prime into fw into f by okay. Now L prime is nothing but L by Cp T naught, where L is heat absorbed by water to raise its temperature from a liquid at T naught to gas at TT3, then that remaining part is accounted for in this portion. Okay, this is where you are taking it from TT3 to the turbine inlet temperature TT4. This part accounts for the latent heat of water that you need to supply for raising its temperature from T naught to turbine inlet temperature. Okay.
Sir, we have to account for methanol also, no?
Huh?
Methanol we are
in this,
adding.
Yeah, I have to say here, in this analysis we have looked at only water. You not accounted for methanol. You can account for it by suitably changing the L value. Okay. L value in that case will get reduced. So the ISP part will be a little higher, okay. Now, if we were to do the same analysis as we had done earlier, that is make a table and look at what happens with increasing percentage of methanol injection, how much is the thrust increment that we get and what is the cost that we need to pay. We will use the same set of values that we had used for the choke nozzle, that is theta b is equal to 5.55, this is at 11 kilometer and m naught is equal to 0.8. Tau C naught would be 2.03 and therefore theta naught would be 1.128 and F, let me keep it as 0.03, A naught is equal to 294 meters per second. Okay. If we have this, then for varying fractions of FW, we can get tau C and as I said only things that change are in that expression are tau C and tau T. So you have 0, then it is 2.03 and this is 12 and this would be 0.8. Which was what we had seen earlier. Now I can put this in kilonewtons. So I'll get 41.8. Now if we increase it to something like 0.2%, okay, then compressor pressure ratio will rise and correspondingly the temperature ratio will rise. It will act as though the compressor is giving out air at 14.5 pressure ratio, whereas the compressor was giving out at 12, it acts as though it is giving out at 14.5 and correspondingly this will also increase and you get a higher thrust, but your ISP will be reduced. And if you further increase it to something like 0.3, this goes to 2.18 and the compressor pressure ratio increases, this increases also. So we see that as the f by m dot a a naught increases, we are also getting an decrease in ISP. This is because we need to add more heat here to increase the temperature. Okay, then I'll stop here. In the next class, we'll look at what happens if we have efficiencies to deal with in the turbojet. Okay, thank you.